piece called the Jazz Waltz Concerto in F. It's a piano concerto. And this is how it got started. It got started as a ballet many years ago. A friend of mine, Ron Hedrick, was a choreographer. And he loved to listen to and dance to what's called a jazz waltz. Now, a jazz waltz is not like a Strauss waltz or European dance. It's a real American dance, and it has a jazz feel. It's very up, it's very happy. You know, it's that kind of thing. It's a three-quarter time, and he asked me to write him a ballet that would last about 15 minutes, 15 to 20 minutes. And I said, Ron, I can do that, but it's going to get a little boring, just the same kind of beat all the time. So what to do? He said, well, I need 20 minutes. I need 15 to 20 minutes. Well, so I started to think about it, and I figured it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I figured, what if I add a couple of numbers to it? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. All of a sudden, there was a new beat. And that shows that the mathematics and music have quite a bit in common. And they can work together very nicely. So when I figured I could do 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I figured, well, if I can do 5, I can add 2, I can add 4. All of a sudden, I created a whole new beat. Well, the next thing, I put 2 3s together, and it became and a 2, and it became an 8. And here I had my ballet. All I had to do is put a little slow part to it, give it a fancy name, Adagio. And I had a ballet of 15 to 20 minutes, and it was a big success. Ron Hedrick staged it beautifully. I never thought the dancers could count that. But they didn't even bother, they just danced it. And so it was a very big success in the 90s in Miami, and that was the end of it. And so I said to myself, well, if I can use this as a ballet, I can use it for a piano concerto. So I wrote myself a piano concerto, I called it the Jazz Waltz Concerto in F, and here it is, ladies and gentlemen, your back of